Have you ever noticed these ditches next to a field? Well, they are everywhere. And because of them, we live in a radically different world today than our great-grandparents did. But what if we would fill them back up? I went to Belgium to transform this mundane old farmland into the glorious biodiverse wetland it used to be, and to find out how sometimes killing trees will help us capture more CO2 than any forest ever could. But I cannot do this alone, so I brought some help. With the help of our community and a lot of shovels, sweat, and some very heavy machinery, we are going to turn this back into this. We are Planet Wild. Welcome to Mission 35. All right, let me show you something. This is a typical European landscape. Lots and lots of green fields. But look what happens when I change the view. These little blue lines are drainage ditches. Their job is to channel any excess surface water into streams and rivers to make the land farmable. Without them, huge parts of Europe would look like this. In fact, it's believed that up to 20% of Europe was covered in wetlands just 100 years ago. And it's estimated that we have lost around 80% of it. Wetlands really have a bad reputation. Our stories depict them as evil, scary places, full of death. But in reality, they are quite the opposite. They act like giant sponges that can retain massive amounts of water, protecting the land from both floods and droughts, while also filtering the water before it flows into rivers and oceans. 40% of all plant and animal species depend on wetlands in some way, and many species can only be found here.
Ce sphaigne squareuse qui est magnifique, ou alors ce camaret des marais, ou le criquet ensanglanté, en fait, ce sont des espèces qu'on retrouve uniquement dans les tourbières.
This is Louise. Her mission is to bring wetlands back to Europe, and I'm here to help her. Louise is part of the team at EcoTree, who are turning degraded landscapes into thriving ecosystems. They have already restored around 2,000 hectares of land across Europe. As the name suggests, they were founded with the vision of planting trees. But when looking for the most effective climate solutions, they were also drawn to wetlands. And a big reason for that is this. This is peat. It might just look like mud, but it's something else entirely. Peatlands are a special kind of wetland. They form in places where water doesn't flow or drain away at all, so they are constantly flooded. This means that when plants die and sink to the ground, oxygen can't reach them. And without oxygen, the microbes that normally decompose these plants simply don't function. And so layer upon layer of dead, undecomposed plants settle into the wet ground and over centuries become peat. And this is where it gets interesting. Since the plants never decompose, the carbon they have absorbed over their lifetime never escapes. This makes peatland ecosystems incredibly effective at capturing carbon. How effective exactly? Well, even though peatlands only cover 3% of all land on Earth, they hold twice as much carbon as all the forests in all the world combined, making it by far the biggest terrestrial carbon sink, which of course is fantastic, except that our peatlands are disappearing fast.
Cette partie de la Belgique a perdu 75% de ses tourbières en juste 60 ans.
And this is why. 1,000 kilometers of ditches were dug in this valley alone in order to drain it completely. Without water, the layers of peat start to dry out and oxygen gets back in. Suddenly, the decomposers that have been absent for millennia are all coming back and get to work. Starting at the surface, they begin to release massive amounts of CO2 as they break down all that ancient plant matter, layer by layer. In fact, draining peatlands makes up 5% of all human-related CO2 emissions worldwide. Imagine a bathtub full of water and then you just pull the plug and everything goes away. That's what happened here. But all is not lost. There's still intact ancient peat deep under the earth. If we don't do anything, it will also dry out, decompose, and release dangerous amounts of additional CO2 into the atmosphere. So it's really a race against time to save it. And that's exactly why we're here. In essence, we need to do four things. Number one, felling trees. It seems brutal and counterintuitive, but these forests don't belong here. Their roots suck the land dry and prevent the much rarer and more delicate peatland ecosystem from returning. Number two, removing unwanted vegetation. In order to keep the land clear, fresh saplings have to be removed by hand for years until the water level is high enough. Number three,
a lot of mowing.
Decades of farming have left behind overly fertilized soil, which, when left alone, allows grass to grow fast and take over. That's why we mow again and again, until the soil is ready to reset and the peatland can return. And number four, put the plug back into the bathtub. And that's what we're actually doing today.
But Marcus, we cannot do it alone.
That's why we brought friends. In a Planet Wild first, we brought a literal busload of our community members out here to Belgium to help us with this tremendous effort.
I'm so happy to be here and get my hands and my clothes and everything dirty.
This here is Dasha, our head of community and impact. And 2 months ago, she sent out an email to the community asking for help. And so many people just responded and said, we'll be there. I mean, if this doesn't restore your faith in humanity, I don't know what does. If you want to become part of Planet Wild yourself, consider joining us as a backer. Every month, we team up with environmental pioneers around the world to clean up our oceans, bring back endangered species, and restore wild landscapes. And all of it is community funded by people just like you. You can give whatever amount, big or small, that feels right to you and become part of these missions yourself. That means you'll see your own impact in monthly videos, just like this one. And who knows, maybe sometime you'll also join us on a mission. There's a link in the description. For this mission, our community are fully funding the restoration of 7.5 hectares of peatland right here in Black Creek Valley. The full reconstruction will take EcoTree and their local partner Natuurpunt 5 years to be completed. Natuurpunt have been restoring this land for decades and have unparalleled local experience. So it's a real dream team. And once the heavy work is done, the real transformation begins. The water table slowly rises back because rain and groundwater stay in the valley. As the water comes back, we're stopping the decomposition process of that deeper peat, some of which is up to 14,000 years old. And that means we're stopping all that carbon from being released into the atmosphere. And then slowly but surely, new layers of peat are starting to form on top, which is a slow process that can take generations. But a lot of the visible biodiversity benefits happen much, much quicker.
Ici, on est dans une tourbière qui a été restaurée il y a 2 ans. Ce qui est intéressant dans cette tourbière, c'est qu'on commence à voir le trèfle d'eau. Et pour le coup, cette espèce, elle est présente uniquement quand on a à nouveau de l'eau dans la tourbière. Donc là, c'est une espèce indicatrice qui montre que les travaux de restauration ont fonctionné.
And it's not only rare plants that are making a comeback. For the first time in modern history, a pair of common cranes successfully returned to Belgium to breed, and they settled down right here in the restored parts of the Black Creek Valley. And after 200 years of absence, even wolves have been spotted in the valley again. Even the beavers are coming back, and of course that supercharges the restoration effort because their dams help to keep the water inside the landscape.
De voir que c'est possible de restaurer des écosystèmes qu'on a complètement dégradés par le passé avec des activités humaines et derrière de pouvoir voir dans le temps petit à petit la biodiversité revenir, c'est hyper satisfaisant.
So we can already see very real progress and slowly but surely the work that we're doing here will transform this back into this. All this is still just the beginning of the Black Creek's comeback. And another amazing example of how this growing community here on YouTube is making a big difference out in the real world. Both the people who funded this mission and those who showed up. If you also want to make a difference, join Planet Wild as a backer by following the QR code over here or the link down in the description. And I really recommend you check out EcoTree's other amazing European projects over on their website and socials. We're linking to them in the description as well. Thank you all for watching. Over and out.